Hi, this is Russell Stanner from teachertrainingvideos.com, and one thing I often get asked is, what is survey in Kahoot? How does a survey work and how does it differ from doing a quiz? Well, essentially the difference between survey and quizzes is not the way you actually create the quiz, but that a survey is for collecting information. So you're looking for opinions rather than for a right or a wrong answer. I think the best way for me to demonstrate this is to actually do one. So I've just opened up a survey that I've created. I'm going to click on preview. Preview is the best way to always look at your Kahoots, because you can see the student's view here on the right hand side, or the teacher's view, whoever you're doing the survey with, and of course you're in control here. So I'm always use classic mode so that only one person needs to put in their name, and what I'm going to do here now is it will quickly generate a pin. So I just simply put that number in, I click on enter, I write my name, and you'll notice that straight away then my name will now appear on the left hand side of the screen, and we're ready to start the game. So we click on start here, and you'll see that the first question will come up on the screen, and you'll see exactly what the student or the whoever you're asking the questions to will see. So we've got four questions and basically we've got to answer, so I'm going to click here. And then what will happen now is that it will give us some survey information about how many people have asked or answered the question and put the first answer, the second answer, the third or the fourth. Now in this particular case, of course, we've only got me answering the questions because I'm doing a test here, but you can see that it doesn't give points for who got the answer wrong or who got the answer right. What it does is simply show you what the distribution of answers was in the group. So again here, if I was going to choose this one, and I might say this answer here, and again the teacher then will see immediately on the screen once everyone's answered the question the distribution of the answers. So it's very much about actually gathering data, so you have to think carefully about the types of questions that you would use in the questionnaire, because you're not looking for a right or a wrong answer, rather you're trying to gather data. You can use that get data for some interesting things afterwards. It could be for students to make a report, or for you to do a report, or to create a discussion, but you're using it to gather information. I've done it sometimes, for example, if I'm working with a group of students, student teachers, and I want to find out a little bit about what technologies they use. So I'm trying to gather data to help me to decide, well, what I'm going to train them on or what I'm going to teach them to use, etc. So very much about information collection. So great for questions, great for feedback after a session, for example, to find out what the users thought of your session and what they'd learned from it. So as I said, it's not really about wrong or right answers, it's very much about getting information. And that is basically the way it works. Now, really quickly, just going to show you, are there any differences when we create a Kahoot? I did very quickly forget to mention, of course, that once you've done a survey, you can gather the results and you can even save them onto your drive or download them as an Excel file. So if you're trying to gather data, then obviously it might be quite useful for you to download the information. As far as the Kahoot itself is concerned, there really is no difference. So you would click on New Kahoot. Now, what's the difference between discussion and survey? Well, a discussion is really like a survey, but with just one question. So I never use the discussion mode. I always use the survey mode. And it's exactly the same as a quiz. But you do need to think slightly differently about the questions, because you're not looking for a wrong or right answer. You're trying to offer a number of possibilities. And then the users obviously answer the questions depending on what their particular choice. So that is really essentially what the difference between the survey and the quiz is. To make them, they're really no different at all. They work in exactly the same way. Keep in mind though that when you do that, you do need to think very carefully about the types of questions that you answer. And of course, at the end of doing the survey, it may be quite interesting for you to download that survey information, and then you can use that for other activities. Perhaps you could even give the survey information to your students. They could do a report or do a presentation based on the information that's been gathered from the survey. So hopefully I've made it clear what a survey is and how it's different to a quiz mode in Kahoot. Hi, this is Russell Stanner from teachertrainingvideos.com. Really hope you found those videos on Kahoot interesting. If you come to the website teachertrainingvideos.com, lots more free videos for you to learn about different technologies that you can use in your teaching and learning. There's a newsletter that you can sign up to. It has about 25,000 subscribers now, but if you're not interested, just click here. One section you might be particularly interested in is mobile technologies, and you're going to get videos about a whole range of different technologies, including Kahoot, Quizlet, and Socrative. So you might want to click there. If you choose any of the videos, when you click on them, make sure that you watch the video full screen. So when you click on a video, you can click here and make it full screen. It makes it a lot more interesting experience to watch the videos. A couple of interesting sections on this website. First of all is what we call the Russell's 5-minute blog. That is very quick videos that just show you a number of key technologies that you might be interested in using in your teaching and learning. And also, you might be interested in signing up to the YouTube channel. I put lots more videos on the YouTube channel, many that I don't put onto the website. Thank you very much.